Kansas City Mayor Sly James didn't just say dangerous buildings were coming down. He took the first one down all by himself. The mayor says there are more than 1,000 abandoned and dangerous buildings in the city, but starting today, that number is on its way down.
And it's all due to the passage of a sales tax increase approved by voters last month. Fox News' Eric Burke has more on the first demolition and the timeline for the rest.
That had been burned, and there's no salvaging it, and the roof is caving.
Stephanie Irving is one of thousands of people who have to stare at an eyesore, but that's going to change.
And over the next 24 months, the council and I want to see those 1,000 dangerous buildings gone.
The first phase of the project, 157 buildings in the urban core, the green impact zone, and the west side.
Our neighborhoods have been begging for this for way too long. And they can't move forward until we help by taking care of our part, getting rid of dangerous buildings.
At $5,000 to $6,000 per building, it won't be cheap to tear them down, but the tab will be paid thanks to voters.
Because of the faith that the voters placed in us on August 7th, we now have the means to do what we said we were going to do.
Mayor Sly James took it one step further by getting behind the controls and helping get the process started. When he was done, he thought about a career change.
I'm officially resigning as mayor and getting a truck in one of those things, man. That's fun.
He's kidding, of course, but he's dead serious about cleaning up neighborhoods across Kansas City. And he says it will be done in a green frame of mind, with some of the demolition done by trained deconstructionists.
Well, they're going to go in and actually pull stuff out and do some things and try and salvage materials that can be reused.
With one down, there's just 156 to go. The deadline for phase one, March 2013. Eric Burke, Fox 4 News, working for you in Kansas City, Missouri.